As you know, a capital gains tax is being recommended for the sale of investment properties, shares and other assets. It's just one of the tax working group's many recommendations in the biggest potential shake-up of our tax system in decades. For more on how it will affect you, we're joined this morning by KPMG tax partner Bruce Bernacchi. Kia ora, Bruce. Thanks for being with us.
It's great to be back.
This is it.
Yeah, so this is it. This was my bedtime reading last night, 200 pages of tax working group. It certainly is. You know, I'm living the dream, right? So 99 recommendations in there, and so a very comprehensive document, very well written, and so they've done a thorough job.
Yeah, they've been thorough, but of course so much of the attention is on the CGT, the capital gains tax. Is there anything about that proposed tax that has come as a surprise to you?
Well, look, the introduction of a CGT is not a surprise, and thankfully I'm not back here on national TV eating my shoes.
Yes,
so
you promised you'd do that.
Yeah, so I don't have to do that, all good. But there were some surprises in there. I think the breadth of the tax, the fact that it's only the family home and certain personal assets, your boat, your car, jewellery, etc., that are out, as are investments in certain foreign shares. Otherwise, everything's in. It's taxed at full marginal tax rates, so there's no adjustments for or indexation for inflation. It's coming in at full marginal rates, whereas other countries will tax capital gains at a lower rate. And there's no discounting. For example, in Australia, if you've owned an asset for more than 12 months, they only tax you on half your capital gain. So none of that. It's one of the most comprehensive and toughest capital gains tax proposals in the world.
It seems a bit miserable that they wouldn't index it for inflation.
Yeah, otherwise you're basically are getting taxed on inflation. If you buy an asset today with $100, goes up in value just due to inflation to $120 and you sell it for $130, you're going to pay tax on that $30 rather than just the real economic gain.
Yeah, okay. What is the chance that this is actually going to pass in its current form?
Well, I'm willing to roll over my shoe challenge here. I'm going to say that in its current form, I don't believe this will be in law on the 1st of April 2021.
Okay.
There's a great article by Liam Dan in yesterday's Herald which suggests that this report has come out recommending a very comprehensive capital gains tax to give the government an argument to scale back to what they really want, which is just CGT on residential properties, which the entire tax working group agrees with. So there's a chance the Labor Party may not go with a full thing. Then you've got to get it past New Zealand first.
Yeah.
And then if the Nats win the 2020 election, they promise to repeal it.
Not going to have it either. Okay, yeah. But if we... I mean, even if they push aside the shares, they push aside the intellectual property, the KiwiSaver, all of those things, and the government just pursues a capital gains tax on residential property, there are some things they could look to soften the blow a bit, right? So if they reduce it from the marginal tax rate to a lower rate, or are there other options that we might have to soften it a bit?
Oh, the two big ones would be tax it at a lower rate, or halve the amount you pay tax on to do some sort of discount. Those are the two big things that are done overseas.
One thing that's interesting to me as well is that this wouldn't be retrospective. So anyone who's had property go up in value astronomically over the last 5 or 10 years wouldn't be affected. Everything would go from April 2020.
Yeah, and that's a really important point because I've spoken to a lot of people who have been scared about assets they've owned for 10 years that have gone up a lot in value, so no. And that's one of the complicated design features. You're only going to be taxed on gains made after the 1st of April 2021, and so assets are going to have to be valued at that date. For residential property, that's easy. You can use council valuations, registered valuations. For shares, you'll have a market value from the NZX. But for other assets, business assets, it's going to be very tough. And so people are going to be given 5 years to actually work out what the assets they owned in 2021 were worth.
Who's going to be most affected?
I would say, people who own residential property and are going to own them for longer than 5 years, so they're outside the existing bright line tests, small business owners, the rural sector, because while there's a carve out for the family home, that only extends to 4,500 square metres of land, so just roughly over an acre around the family home. Everything else is in the net. So anyone who owns a decent amount of property. I mean, if you want to get out of this tax, I've got two things.
Yeah, please.
Free advice
please,
here, Jack.
Yeah.
So buy a bigger house. So if you've got spare money lying around, Jack, I'm sure you do. Like all you millennials do, buy a bigger house because any increase in the value of your family home is not going to be taxed.
Well, this is the danger. Like in countries where they have a capital gains tax that doesn't include the family home, people end up building McMansions, right?
Exactly. It's called the mansion effect,
yeah,
right? And the other one is buy foreign shares. So at the moment, you're not taxed on gains on shares made on shares in New Zealand companies and on listed Australian shares. There's a special regime for foreign shares. Mm-hmm. You pay tax on a deemed 5% return. But if you think that you're going to buy shares in a foreign company that's going gangbusters, and it does, you're not going to pay capital gains tax on it. So pile into your offshore equities.
There are quite a few Kiwis who could potentially be a little bit better off if this was to pass, right?
So the package is revenue neutral, and that's an important point. So they're expecting it to raise $8 billion over the next 5 years. Mm. And what the working group has done has given a range of recommendations on how you could spend that. Mm. And they've given four sort of package examples of how it could be spent. Each one of them proposes increasing the threshold of the bottom tax rate, which applies at a 10.5% rate, currently sits at $14,000, and their proposals to increase that to $20,000 or even up to $30,000.
So Michael Cullen reckons that's about 15 bucks a week in the back pocket.
Yeah, $430 minimum to everybody. And then there are other changes around reducing or eliminating the tax on KiwiSaver contributions for people earning less than $48,000. Mm. Other options to increase the amount of the government's tax credit when you put money into KiwiSaver. The government puts in 50 cents up to a maximum of $1,024 a year, looking at increasing that. So it's not all bad news.
Okay. If this is a 9 out of 10 in terms of grit and strength and how comprehensive it all is, what do you think will actually pass?
Oh, I think 5 out of 10 will pass.
Right.
If I was going to put money on it,
I think
there's a very good minority view. Only 3 out of the 8 members of the committee endorse the full CGT. I think the minority view is what we might end up with, which is just a capital gains tax on residential property.
Thank you so much for your time and your insight, Bruce. And your free tax advice. Fantastic.
All right.
Bruce Bernacchi from KPMG.
Thank